All right, naturally the question, Reverend, how do I condition my mind for money? How do I do it? I'm sold on the idea that I can. Now just tell me exactly how do I do it. All right, I'm going to give you some of the ways and means. Number one, by thinking positively about money. And talking positively about money. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. In other words, may I think in my favor. May I speak in my favor. And all cross-examine yourself also with these questions. Am I thinking in my favor? Am I speaking in my favor? Again, the scripture says, life and death are in the power of the tongue. Oh, if you only knew the power of your tongue. You'd bite it more often. Physicists tell us that each time we speak, the molecules in our, the atoms in our body change places. You see, every time you speak, so much happens in the unseen world that appears later in the objective world. Every time you think something or say something positive about money, something happens. Something positive happens. You set up positive vibrations about money, which at some point in time and space must appear in your experience. And whenever you think and say anything negative about money, something negative. You send out negative vibrations about money, and at some point in time and space, that must also appear in your experience. The Bible tells us that the worlds were made by the word of God. But here's the mind blower. Each person creates his own world. Each person speaks his own world. Each person thinks and speaks his own world into existence. There are almost 2,000 of us here tonight, sitting side by side, some of you physically touching each other, but yet each one lives in his own world. And what creates your world of experience? Your word, what you think and what you say. So you see, you are the God who speaks your own world into existence, thinks your own world into existence. So all of your thinking about money ought to be positive. I had an interesting experience, again, many, but this is one of them. I don't think I've told you about yet, the experience that I had on the campus of Atlanta University a couple of weeks ago. A student, young lady from the state of Mississippi, approached me after one of the lectures and said to me, Reverend Ike, I don't have any money. And the Reverend Ike, I don't care what you say, I don't have any money, and that's a fact. I said, and what do I do about that? Here again, I don't say that, I don't argue with the existence of so-called matter. I don't argue with the existence of so-called facts. And the young lady just, you see, she wanted me to know, look, I don't have any money. I'm flat broke. You know, and you know, I don't tell me this stuff about the mind. It's a fact. But I got you now. So what do I do? What do I start with? I said, well, whenever there is a negative fact that you face, do not think and speak the negative fact, but find out some positive statement to make about every negative situation. I said, and here it is. Here's the cure. Here's the answer. It is a fact now that you have no money, but do not continue to think and to speak that negative fact, because as long as you continue to think it and speak it, that fact will remain a fact. But instead of speaking it, find something positive to say, like, I see myself having all of the money that I need. That's right. I see myself having all of the money that I need. And here again, I go back into something that I told them in Atlanta, I believe the final Sunday also, and I've said it even way back in at the sunset at some other point. You know, there's a difference between truth and fact. Poverty is a fact. Yes, it is. Poverty is certainly a fact. But poverty is not the truth. And if you're in the fact of poverty, you're going to remain in the fact of poverty as long as you go around thinking and speaking that fact of poverty. But you have to realize that poverty is not the truth of you. The truth of you is, as David said in the 23rd Psalm, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. So you have to reject it. Poverty is not the truth of me. Let me hear every one of you saying that. Come on. Poverty is not the truth of me. See, you have to know that. This isn't the truth of me. Yes, sickness is a fact, but you don't have to bow down to that. You see, sickness is not the truth of me. Health is the truth of me. Together, sickness is not the truth of me. Health is the truth of me. And you see here again, this is what Jesus meant when he said, you shall know what? The truth. And what does the truth do? Set you free. But the truth is, too many times we know all the negative facts. You see, like that young lady from Mississippi with no money, she knew the negative fact. And she wanted to let me know that she knew the negative fact and that there was no way that I was going to talk her out of that negative fact. I don't have any money. That's fact. All right, if you insist on it, you can have that fact. But you can change that fact. You see, that's another thing. Facts should never be your master. You should be the master of facts. Always remember that. And you can change anything that you can change your mind about. I can change anything that I can change my mind about. Together, I can change anything that I can change my mind about. If I can change my mental vision from the fact to the truth. Yes, unhappiness, for example, is a fact. Psychiatrists have told us that one of the greatest sicknesses, that the greatest sickness that there is depression. People who feel low and blue and sad, discouraged, disgusted, lonely, depressed, oppressed, suppressed, and unpressed. And those are facts. But you see, unhappiness is not the truth of me. The truth is that the joy of the Lord is my strength. And I must know this truth, and this truth sets me free. Had quite an interesting session with the writer who's handling the editorial work on my autobiography today, talking about my early experiences and so on and so forth. But you know, even while I was experiencing the fact of poverty, there was something in me that knew better. There was just something in me that knew better. You know, it's like the prodigal son. He was in that far country. But there was something in him that knew better. And the Bible says he came to himself, his true self. And you see, we only experience these negative things when for some reason or the other we get away from the true self and get lost in the world of facts. seeing you have no business getting lost in the world of facts. Know the truth and be free. You see, because in fact there are poor people, but in truth there are no poor people. There are only people who do not know their riches in God. God does not have any poor children. Only children who have forgotten that they're rich in God.